Jordan Price here in Pendleton, Indiana. And what I'm going to talk about today, you know, this is kind of a revisit. Roland VR-3 AV video mixer. And I did talked about this a while back, and I had a audio snafu, and I'm going to show you going in what happened on that. I need to switch up here to another camera and get him ready here. And on the left side, it has you can put up to four XLR mics or quarter inch mics, and it also has phantom power for mics. And it's got for our one set here, two, each one of these controls two mics, each one of these phantom power plug control two mics. So if you would have only two mics require phantom power, you can just switch one over, and if all four of them or none of them, then you can set the switch accordingly. But it also has, see if it's going to focus, internal mics. And this on the left has a mic here, and then over here on the right a mic, and that is controlled there above the 7-8 control. And what happened last time is that I had that open, and I also had the main mic open, and it just really messed up the audio. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to run down my mic here, and I'm going to crank up the internal mic. And I had both mics running, and the audio just was screaming awful. And but the Roland says that put that on, this capability on there says sometime you may want to pick up some of the background sound. Now I'm back on my mic now, but pick up some of the background sound if you're doing a concert or if you're doing some other kind of live show. It also has a reverb right here, and crank it up a little bit, and I had it squeal on me a while ago, so I'm not going to go up any higher. But I don't know if I'll use that, or it's going to come into play when I'm out doing some kind of event or something like that. But each mic, and again, is four. You put up four XLR or one quarter mics here on the left side. Each one has its own slider for volume, and the gain, EQ, high and low, and pan. And then it has the main volume there on the right side of the board. Now there's 5 and 6. I'm going to switch up to another camera here and cut over. Now you're looking at the back, you're looking at the left rear, and you can bring in external audio here and that to the back, to the Roland VR-3, or you bring in PC audio, which is 7 and 8. And those again are controlled, back up over here, 5 and 6 are on a slider here, and that's for your external audio. And then for your PC audio, the level out there are controlled there. For your cameras, now I have four cameras hooked up, although you only see three lit. I had this little guy hooked up too, and it works. The problem with it, I could not cut off the information display, how the battery charge and how long the video had been recording, so on and so forth, and that showed up in a picture, so I decided not to use that. The cameras I have hooked up now, on the left over there is a Canon XHA1S. In front of the window, it's a Canon FS200, a camera I've had for a long time. And getting video or pictures from the rear is a Sony security camera there. Now you can switch which camera is primary or displaying with these buttons. And every time it lights up and also puts a red border around the camera that is primary. There's two and there's three. And go back, and you can also switch those just by lightly tapping on the window to change which camera is primary. Now this is the monitor. What you're looking now is the cameras. You got three cameras that are powered up, and you see those three cameras there. You can also see what your output looks like here. Now this freeze is to freeze the last frame of a recording if you're doing a recording, and Roland has a program that's free. You can download it to record video from the Roland VR3 and 5 and video equipment, and again you download that and it works pretty well, and I've that's free. Just download that. The menu, pop up the menu, and you can change different settings. Your transition time, a wipe, picture to picture, split, or your key. And that is the value here, that's what changes those. And then you can do a green screen with it. And your fade, how it's going to fade out, black or white, you can change that there, and that's on the right side. You can also do a cut, mix, or wipe when you transition, and you can also do a picture and a picture. Now we're going to, I've been playing around with that picture and a picture some, so we're going to give that a try. Now I've got the main camera on, let's see, let's go to camera 3, and this is the back, and then we're going to do a picture to picture, and that is going to be me. So, and you can change the position of that picture-to-picture just by putting your finger on that insert and drag it around wherever you want to be. I'll switch back over here and just move it around like that. And you can also do a split. And there is a split. And then your key for your green screen over here is just really cool. And there we go. Now we're going to take a look at some things on the back of the Roland VR3, and I'm going to switch over to the back camera, the security camera. Again, you got your audio coming in right and left, and your PC audio. Now, if you got a PC hooked up to it, and you're playing a video, and you want the audio of the video as one of those displays, then you can bring the audio in too. Let me get back up again to this camera and go back over these buttons real quick. Again, camera 1, 2, 3, 4. And 4 is also a PCN, can be a PCN. Now, if you got a AV hooked up to 4, it's going to be primary, but you can have three cameras and a PC to play titles or video or something like that with that button, overlay titles or play a video. Now, let's go back to the back again and go back over. Now, coming on over. I've got four cameras plugged in. Three are powered. And those black cords here are just extensions. Come on over. You got your PC in. And go out to a monitor here. And PC in here. Video out. If you got large monitors out in your audience, you want them to be able to see on different screens. You got can put monitors out there, or a preview of what you're doing, a larger screen if you want to use something other than the screen on the VR3. Audio out, if you're running audio out to a mixing board for your external displays, it's either RCA or 1/4. Now, USB out, that's what I'm capturing this video with to my computer. And then your power, and you can also power this by a battery called pedal power. And it powers it for quite a long time. If you're out someplace you don't have any electricity. So again, it's a neat device. And again, Roland makes a capture program that you can use to capture if you're not live streaming. And that's what the USB would be for. You could live stream or capture it on your computer. They also make a capture program that's free, and download that for the VR 3 and 5. And that VR5, again, I'd really like to take a look at that VR5. That is a tremendous, tremendous device. So if you have any questions, comments about this review, please feel free to drop a comment or a question down below, and I'll do the best I can to answer them for you. From Pendleton, Indiana, hoping you have a great, great day. This is George Price.